So I reckon Texas girl got slammed in a vlog for being a negative, vindictive woman, yet she loves God. Well, me and...
That sounds like something maybe... Are you sure they're not talking about you, Tammy?
Texas girl can deal with it. I hope she can. Is she bold enough to say what she wants to? I reckon so. Let me think. Yep.
Haven't you been talking about this lady the last few days? I think you have, because you've been talking about just about everybody the last few days. If they're not on Bombshell's team, because let me break this down. Whew, it's crazy too. You hate Savage, and you know Savage and Bombshell are arguing, but you hate Savage so much that you now are going to join over here with Bombshell. You don't fly alone. You're not an eagle like you say you are. The only thing eagle on you is a spread eagle, and you know we all know about what you are. You are what you are. Now, as far as Bombshell goes, I honestly have nothing against Bombshell. I honestly have nothing against Savage. I think the whole thing, what I do think is wrong is this shutting this shit down with this Toys for Tots. This is bullshit. This is bullshit. Whoever's saying shit about it is wrong. There are so many kids out there that need help. There's so many families out there that are struggling to even buy Christmas. This was a very nice thing. A great opportunity to get some kids some presents. And who's fucking that up? I'm looking at her. It's you. It's you. And Bombshell's people aren't helping the matters at all. Not at all. And if you guys don't like it that I'm saying it, too fucking bad. You all should be ashamed of yourselves. If maybe the community where Savage lives doesn't have a whole lot of people that can help, and maybe that's why she's doing it. She's not asking everybody to send. Maybe when she gets enough, she's going to say, I've got enough for our community. And I'm sure she will. But you guys are acting like this woman has went off and committed murder. She's collecting fucking toys. What do you think she's going to do? Steal the crayons? Steal the little matchbox toys? The gifts are like $5 to $10. You guys are acting like fucking idiots over this. I'm embarrassed for you people. I truly am. And then I got this goddamn fucking idiot making videos for me telling me, if I were you, I'd blow my brains out. Well, guess what? I am me and I wouldn't ever do that. That's the sort of shit you say you're going to do to yourself. I love myself too much to do something like that. Tammy, you need to go see a doctor. You got some serious issues going on. Serious. Next.
People are cutting down her identity and her looks. I don't have anything against her. Because that's me.
And see? That's wrong, too. Why do they have to cut down, I think her name's Texas Girl or Texas Lady or something. Why do they have to cut down her looks? Who's doing that? Is that Bombshell's people doing that? Because once again, they, you know, I'm pretty sure it is. Whoever's doing it is in the wrong. It's in the wrong. They didn't like it when people were saying mean things to Bombshell. So why are they saying mean things? It'll never stop. If it just keeps going and going and going and going, it'll never fucking stop. It makes no sense to me at all. I don't understand why people that have no avatar make fun of people's looks. It drives me nuts. If you're going to make fun of somebody, you better have big enough balls to put your picture up. That's just not right, in my opinion. Those kind of people don't bother me. They don't bother me at all, really, because I can imagine what they look like. I mean, if they can't put their picture up, next.
I will tap on a channel and not even know they're evil and then get damned.
Oh, poor Tammy.
Poor Tammy. People don't know you at all. They think they do. Because Savage is at the boiling point. Everybody's got to pay attention to that scaredy cat. Let me explain.
You don't know how to explain anything, Tammy. You get shit wrong. You lie. You tell half-truths or no truths. That's the way you always have been. You never tell the real truth about shit. I want to know why you said that. When I lived in that same state that she's doing this Toys for Tot thing, I had to get toys from Tots. I got a little baby doll. And then 6 months ago and 6 months from now, we'll hear how you were rich at that age. We've heard so many stories about your childhood, Tammy. You're a fucking liar. It's just to whatever fits your narrative, right?
Explain. These little girls with these big mouths, if we were out here in this storm, if they were with me, and I said, let's go now, girls. What we got to do is we got to walk from this bullet point to Clinton. Good Lord. Call the Uber. Where is my phone? My hair, you know.
Now, yeah, that's what you would be saying. Because actually, you wouldn't even leave the house. Because the last time you had a storm, you were like, where is my Seroquel? Where's my Seroquel? I got to get my Seroquel. You were scared to death. This is coming. I got a video on it. I got it, honey. I can pull it. You ran into the kitchen. You said the wind got so high that you had to run into the kitchen, get you some Seroquel. I think you said you took two even. Got in the bed, covered your head up, and fell asleep because you were scared of the storm. Right? Am I right? Yeah, I'm right. Just like you like to do. Was I right? Am I right? Yeah, I'm right. Tammy, you're so full of shit. You ain't gonna be out there getting in the little dinghies and getting across the river and catching all the fish and getting all the animals and skinning them and getting the fires. But you could not do that. You could not do that. You think you can, but you could not do that. Okay? I could do that way better than you could. I've done it. My uncles were trappers. We were fishermen. We were very poor when we were little. Not your poor, not the bullshit poor, okay? I love how you said that I didn't have a hard child life. Let me put it to you this way. I had a mother that was just like you. Oh my God, can you imagine? The very thought of having YouTube when she was alive, oh, thank God. Thank you, Father, for protecting me on that. That would have been a nightmare because she'd be on there doing the same things you're doing, the same things. That's why at first I was kind of like, you know, Mom had just died when I first saw you, and I thought, well, the quirkiness in her is the fun parts that I like to see because Mom had those quirkiness in her too, but you have the same damn evilness in her. I don't know. She never did get diagnosed. She was in many, many, many psychiatric hospitals. My older sister practically raised me. I consider her my mom. She's 5 years older than me. My mom lived with me my whole life, but there were times where she'd be gone, you know, 30 days, 45 days a stint, another 30 days a stint, might have two in 1 year, three in 1 year, who knows? But yeah, she was a very unstable, unhinged woman, just like you. And she would say mean and hateful and ugly, terrible things. The one thing she never said, and she wasn't, is she wasn't racist and she wasn't homophobic. She had a gay grandson, which is my son. She had two gay grandsons because my sister has a gay son. So there you go. Now you can get a little more ammo on me. So she's not homophobic by any means, and she's definitely not racist. And so that's where your differences are. But everything else, you're just like her. You're just like her. She could be a mean, mean person. And a lot of times I had to stay away from her, and she hurt my feelings bad when I was little. And It would cut like a knife. But see, you're not my mom, and I don't have to put up with it from you. So maybe I don't know. I ain't going to put up with none of your shit. I put up with her shit because she was my mom. I'm damn if I'm going to put up with your shit, especially since you act the same way. So that ain't going to happen. Okay? Let's see what the next thing you got to say is.
I can't walk anymore. You know, that's sorrowful. Weak, you know. I can't do this, you know. Then we graduate to a forest. Four cars filled with these people on YouTube running their mouth. Claiming we're without the evil. Four cars, Natchez Trace will choose. Yeah. We'll go there on that dark, dark trace. What's happening? We got.
I think she's doing one of those fantasy things she does. She does sometimes. Sometimes she pretends she's in court and she does these little fantasy things. And I think this is what she's doing here. I don't know. Next.
Gotta get out of here, you know? That's where they are. What is that over there? I'd be the one to say, get behind me and be quiet.
Yeah, right, Tammy. Are you kidding me? You talk so big and bad. Like I said, you'd be popping pills and going to sleep, just like you did when you had a bad windstorm not too long ago. Such a fucking liar.
Gosh, I'm telling the truth, man. Check this out. Check these Merry Christmas thingies out. That's right. Yeah, I'm telling the truth, man. If four vans were all together and you had some of these dummy women on it, what's happening out here? Get us out of here. You know, that kind of nonsense.
That would never happen.
Yeah. Yes. They'd be scared. What's going on here? They might cry themselves to death.
See, Tammy,
I don't have that kind of fear. Let me put it bluntly. If we landed on the trace and we're out of there, I'd be like...
Let's see if any dumbasses are in here. No, just Amy Williamson. I don't know who... I think she's real sweet, though. I don't remember really, but I think she is a real sweet girl. All right, let's keep going.
Well, I'll be dear. Let me figure this out. What we gonna do here in the dark? Hell, anybody use their phone flashlights instead of saving the battery power dummies? In the car, you need the redneck battery way. You need another vehicle that's just don't run, or you have an availability to buy another battery, and you put it there in the back seat and on your trunk, and when your battery cables need to deal with it, you got a battery to deal with it, sucker. Understand?
Did you go over to Gillis's house about 2 or 3 days ago? You act like you have been, if you know what I'm saying. The last two or three days, you act like you've been over there, if you know what I'm saying. I think everybody else out there knows what I'm saying. Been awfully talkative lately. Let's see. I got something here. Let me show you. You been over there lately? Huh? You been over there lately? At your mother-in-law's house? You been awful talkative lately. Doing lots of videos. You did about a six-hour video yesterday. This is like, what, your fourth or fifth today? Yeah, I'd say that you took a trip up to see Gillis, didn't you? Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Oh, well, next.
These women that go... Can anybody jump me off my batteries? I need new battery. Really? Okay. Let me explain. Once again, if you have all this money, here is the stupid, and it shall work. Get your hands on another battery. Take it easy now. Hang in there. When you lift up your hood, yeah, you're like, oh God, the car won't start. You don't have to worry about a tow truck. a buddy that knows what the fetch to do? No. You say, I have a lot of money. For Christmas, you need to buy an additional battery and put it in the back of your car or trunk.
No, I call the tow truck. They come and get it. And when I get to the dealership of my choice, someone there will drive me home. And then they call me when it's fixed. Next.
To survive that dark, wicked, scary road, quit worrying about your hair and nails and stuff. Get that there battery and sit in that car that, you know what's going to happen during that time and place where you're scared. Your battery will run all the time, Sorry. Except in a place that you be scared.
No.
Yeah. That's when she shows up. You'd be like, hey. Oh my gosh, these girls, right? These big mouth women who are scared. Okay, let me explain one more time from Raymond Mississippi's trailer. LLC, not mine.
Come see me.
What you need to do, girls, it doesn't have to be some superior molecular battery. It don't have to. It doesn't have to match the one in your Lincoln Town car and or Tulsa and wish I could have a Bentley. You just go to that store and say, what's the cheapest battery you got?
I knew she was going to say that. I knew she was going to say that. Tammy, you would buy the cheapest battery you could get. You know why? That's why your shit constantly breaks down. You get what you fucking pay for. Do you not know that? Oh, okay, how much is this battery? $12.99. How much is this one? $29.99. How much is that one? $59.99. What about that last one right there? How much is it? $99.99. Why the difference? Well, they last longer and blah, blah, blah. And, you know, this is the top one, the $9.99 or $99.99. You know, it's going to last the longest. And Tammy would go down here and buy the $10.99 one. And she'd have to be back, what do you think, 4 or 5 weeks later, buying another $10 one because it's just going to go out. When she could buy the $99.99 one, put it in, and it would probably last 2 or 3 fucking years. But she doesn't buy like that. I don't understand. She'll buy the lowest price thing. I mean, literally, she puts $5 worth of gas in when she goes to the gas station. People like that drive me nuts. Just get what you need and take care of it. I don't understand it. Or just wait till you got the money to take care of it and then do it all at once. It drives me crazy when people do shit like that. Get your shit together. Damn. Next.
Secondary batteries, you know, at AutoZone, O'Reilly's, that kind of deal. And you go in there and say, I just need a battery. And if they say, do we need to place it in your vehicle? Say, no, I need it in my trunk. They might look at you like a sunflower. Good morning. Something like that. And you get away with that and feather away and keep flying like an eagle saying, boy, that person is stupid as a rock. Then you out on the trace, all broken and contrite, freaking out. And you call, honey, whoever that honey might be, because we don't know these days. Get on, the battery won't start. I'm stranded out here on a dark road. You know, all that freaking scaredy cat garbage. Then you're prepared. Yeah, you're like, well, I put it in drive. Put that hood up. Make sure you got a lock somewhere now. You're going to have to see how to jump it off. All right? Mm-hmm. Then you grab that said battery. You hit it. Yeah, you open up that hood and look down on this lock right here. See? You can get one of these suckers and put some garbage in. Something like that with batteries and stuff. Maybe your phone. Save your battery power on your phone because you're going to be terrified out there, scared. And you're like, you sit there, you put the sucker in park, turn her off. You creeping out, seeing deer. What is that? I heard something, honey, stay on the line with me. That sort of deal. That's those kind of women. Me, no. If I have to stay out there all night to wildlife and fishery gives me. There's that fun fact. I'm out there in the dark. But if you can deal with it, you don't need no immaculate toolbox, girls. For that battery? No. No. You can have a screwdriver if you need one to make sure it ain't the damn starter. You know? You can have one of your basic pliers to tighten up the garbage if you need to be that way. It's, ah! What was that I just heard? Oh, what was that, you know? Squirrel! You know, that fear thingy. And you know that you would. Mm-hmm. I can't make this stuff up if I tried. I've seen women and men do it. I've seen dudes do it. What are we going to do? I'm thinking, Lord, Lord. And I always ask them, do you have a battery in the trunk? Normally, the average brain says, do we have the booster cable thing? Jumper cable thing. That's all right and fine and it's dandy root. You better have one, dummy. Do we have booster cables? Operative word, booster, like a child.
Not booster, the jumper.
Now, fraidy cat women, you'll take this, break this, and learn or not. Remember to love me, hate me, tolerate, or learn something from me. Click off, man, and go find somebody talking about you, Jack, so you can get some material. Get them chunk change. What are men?